Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in today's video we are discussing about HashiCorp Vault. Vault is a tool from HashiCorp organization for securely storing and accessing the secret. Secret is nothing but all the credentials like password, certificate or APIs. Vault has so many features to use. I am using a bare minimum vault function for storing the server credentials. Let me start with a problem statement. 60 to 70% organization is still storing the server credential either in plain text or Excel sheet in a centralized location. There is no auditing available. Who is accessing and when? To overcome this problem, I started using the Vault and I found very useful. So let's go ahead and install and configure the HashiCorp Vault to store server-side credential for your organization. I'm using the Ubuntu 18 machine for this demonstration. You can download the Vault executable from the Vault website. I'm using the latest version of Vault. I am downloading the Vault 1.0.3. I have downloaded the Vault zip file. Let's unzip the Vault executable. It is done. This is the Vault executable. Copy the Vault executable in user bin folder. Now let's create a couple of the directory for the Vault configuration. Let's create a folder called Vault under the etc folder to keep all the Vault configuration files. Let's create the another folder called Vault-data under the opt location to store all the secrets, and one more directory for Vault logs. Now let's create the Vault config file. This is the complete Vault configuration file for this demonstration. The first part is listener. Listener configure the address and port on which Vault will respond to the request. This is the example of multi interface on which Vault will listen. Private interface as well as localhost. We are disabling the TLS. By default, TLS is enabled for the Vault configuration. Next one is a storage. Storage configure the storage backend of Vault information. In this demonstration, I'm using the storage type file and this is the path of my local storage. You can look at the documentation. There are many service providers who support the Vault storage, like Azure, Cassandra, DynoDB, File System, MySQL, etc. It is lease duration for tokens and secret, and UI interface is true. It means that we are going to access Vault on the browser. Let's save it. Now let's create the Vault service. This is the content of the Vault service file. I am not explaining this file. You can get this file from my GitHub account. I will provide the link in the description. Let's go ahead and save it. Now let's try to start the Vault service and check the status of the service. It is running. Try to access the service on the browser. This is the private IP address of the machine. Yes. It is available. We require to set up the Vault now. Let's set up or initialize the Vault. First one is key share. It is asking how many numbers to split the master key into. As per the recommendation, I am splitting the master key into 5 pieces. And second one is key threshold. It is asking how many keys required to recreate the master key. I am using the recommendation value 3. It means that my master key is going to split in 5 pieces. If I provide any 3 out of 5 piece, it will recreate the master key. Let's go ahead and initialize. This is the root token. Root token is required initially to login in the Vault console. Go ahead and download all keys. This is the master key and it is splitted into 5 pieces. You required any of 3 to recreate the master key. Basically, you required a master key to unseal the vault. This is the root password or token to login into vault service. When vault start or restart, it doesn't know how to decrypt data. It means that it start in sealed and we require to vault to unsealed so that it can read and decrypted your secret. To unseal the vault, you require to supply the master key. So let's unseal the vault. You required 3 pieces of the master key to unseal it. Since we have already downloaded the master key, so this is the one. Now you can see here 1 out of 3 keys provided. Let's go for second one. 2 out of 3 key provided and go with the last one. It's done. Now we require to login in the vault with the root token or root password to add users and configure the policies. This is my root token. I am inside.